I glanced at my watch just before I started this video. It is at 3:03 and 33 seconds. Go figure. This is a very, 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 very momentous day. The world is in an incredibly momentous situation, and therefore this video being commentary on the situation is very much worth your time to take a listen to. I'm going to share some very amazing information. When one cycle is being replaced by another cycle of existence, and remember, existence is a training program to try and teach spirit how to die to what it is, so it can become something different than what it is, and therefore can imagine itself to be prime creator instead of remaining as it is, which is the prime created. When these two cycles overlap, one is coming to an end, another one is overlapping it, you get what is called a stalemate. A stalemate. And interestingly enough, this is the prime time for spirit, true depth of spiritual understanding to take place during this stalemate between two cycles, because then you can realize that neither one is right. That all these cycles need to be replaced by the Holy Spirit's perfect stalemate, the perfect no to the ego's, yes, we can learn how to die. The Holy Spirit says, no, we can't. No, we can't. So you've had this overlap. You have this new cycle charging in with its leader saying, yes, we can, yes, we can, yes, we can. And it's overlapped the old cycle, and you've had this stalemate process taking place. And it started very strongly in 1979. 1979 was the last time the United States and Iran had official talks, President Carter at that time. Now today we have had the breaking of that stalemate. What we find today is the breaking of the stalemate, okay, that has been in place when two cycles have been overlapping. We also have the struggle over health care, okay, and over the funding of the government, and that is being broken also today. We have the stalemate between, on all the social issues, the stalemate between the New World religion and Christianity. The Pope is breaking that stalemate. Across the board, you have the most significant breaking down of stalemates between the old cycle and the new cycle. See, the new cycle, gay marriage is another one. Okay, the breaking down of that, a rapid breaking down of that stalemate. The new way of the new cycle is now crushing the old way, the old cycle, and its ways. And so it's been, what, how many years since 79? 34 years or so. And now the contact between Iran and the United States and is breaking that stalemate, the stalemate over the Syrian situation, chemical weapons, and, you know, the breaking of that stalemate. Across the board, we have the ending of stalemates. You can feel that it's coming to an end. And between the conservatives and the liberal progressives, you have that's been a huge stalemate, right? Over the last 30 years, there's been this ferocious fight. That is coming to an end as the old way is being crushed. The fight over traditional roles, traditional marriage is being crushed by the new cycle. So the new cycle is crushing everything. The old cycle is crushing it. But we had a period there for about maybe 33 years or so. Let's say 33 years, and there's 33 again. Then it's 1980 to 2013. 33 years of overlap. And this is the time when one is able to, since neither side is predominating, you're able to think outside the box and say, now wait a minute, this old cycle wasn't so good, and this new cycle also isn't so good, you know, and neither one is really that good. And then you can listen to the Holy Spirit at that time. So we've had 33 years of grace, I would call it. Very interestingly, I first started studying A Course in Miracles in 1978, in the summer of 1978, and got it started just in time for this 33-year cycle. and was published, I think, to the public in, what, 76 or something like that. Widely available. So it came out just before this cycle began, this 33-year cycle began, of stalemate, of overlapping cycles in the world. So you may be saying right now, aha, I'm hearing it, and it suddenly it's clicking into place. Like, oh my gosh, we have really been in this cycle of grace, actually. And during this time, we've had the greatest opportunity to really think outside the box, which I've been able to do, fortunately, and have just gone like all out, like it was a complete emergency, greatest opportunity possible during these 33 years of just intense effort, 33 years plus, but got the ball rolling, and then into that 33-year period, it's been just an all-out effort, capped off by my rejection of the offer to continue with a new cycle of existence, which happened yesterday by this entity, which seemed to encapsulate, you know, the attractiveness that would push you into another world cycle, and I disregarded it, sidestepped it, and disregarded it. And there's a little bit of this feeling backlash coming now. It's like, why, boy, maybe I made a mistake. Maybe I could have gotten energized and focused on the beauty and attractiveness of another cycle of existence. And so what's going to happen to me now? I rejected it, you know. But it's just fleeting stuff. I just notice it. So the most important thing now I'm going to tell you is I received this incredible experience in 2004. And it was like there was this incredible buildup. I was at the beach of dark, heavy, cold air, saturated with cold spray from the ocean, and the sun was just like almost blotted out by it. It was just this horrible atmosphere built up, and I was like saying, "Wow, we got to get out of here. This day's never going to clear up. I mean, it's never going to get better." And I was told, "Why don't you wait just about 15 minutes? Or wait till the 15-minute mark, okay?" So we waited, and said, "Okay, what the heck?" And suddenly, this miraculous transformation occurred, where a pressure system came in, and literally, gradually, this beautiful, balmy, warm stream of warm air came in, and it started pushing all this horrible, cold, deathly type of atmosphere out away from the shore. And in a matter of 15 minutes or so, really, the atmosphere had completely changed into like this paradise-like atmosphere. And it was just the most stunning thing I think I've ever experienced on this planet. And that stuck with me. From that point, the number 15 has been all important. I've been trying to understand, what is this 15th anniversary, this moment of 15 years anniversary? Is there something to do with 15, reaching a 15-year point, where at that point would be the decisive point, and you have to wait until that point. So last night, while I was posting a video, I happened to look at Google, the search site. I think it was after midnight, and here it was, 15. I said, "Whoa!" It struck me immediately. 15. What is this 15? 15th anniversary of Google, which Google is the figurehead, the masthead, the figurehead of the new cycle. Okay. And it's just turned. It's been around now for 15 years. Today is the anniversary. Marks the 15th year of Google. You see. And then I saw it, I knew that was it. That was the wait until 15. Because right on this very day, we have this breaking of the stalemate, which has been going on with Iran and the Middle East, geopolitical. The geopolitical stalemates are breaking down as the new world order, the new cycle, is now coming into existence full throttle at this point. And at this point, it's no longer really possible to evaluate things very clearly if you haven't done it already. Because it will seem, people will say, oh my gosh, peace, 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 we're having peace, finally we're peace, finally we're getting things the way we want. And you lose your perspective. The grace of the stalemate period is over on this date. Very interesting what's going on. So we're headed towards now this you know, October situation, which has been pointed out by many. October 1st has been pointed out, all the plans for martial law, containment of the civilian population, re-education camps, all this stuff has been set up to be ready by October 1st, 2013. So, you know, something ahead of time is aware that this is the end of some cycle. The overlap is finished. In comes this comet. Comets usually herald the end of something and the beginning of something else. They're a catalytic event situation. The sun is likely to play a very important role too. This comet may affect the functioning of the sun in some way. So we are at now the point where all of this is happening to generate a new cycle of existence, a new phase of the training program. So as far as I can tell, the next day, in this next several days, is likely to be incredibly fruitful in terms of spiritual help. For some reason, I was told we have to wait to this 15th, the mark of 15 was reached. And it just happens to coincide with the end of the world stalemate. Essentially, there is now going to be dialogue happening between, and another stalemate between Christianity and Islam. There's another stalemate, okay? Across the board, you can find all these huge, you know, the cultural wars that have been taking place. All of these things, they've been eroding. The old cycle has been losing ground, losing ground, losing ground, and then suddenly it's going to... very interesting. Very interesting. That shift over at the beach was not necessarily a good thing, actually. It wasn't the best of things, because what happened was that the world seemed very, very attractive. And that's what I experienced after that. Actually, I got off on a bad tangent after that. Very bad tangent. Which was symbolized yesterday by this freak meeting that took place, not being a freak juxtaposition of this energy that is pushing towards a new cycle of existence. So the change is going to happen soon. There's going to be a big, big change in the attitudes of the world. And the young people, the people who have this, I call the God-Goddess complex, about we can make this world paradise, they're going to take over. They're going to be suddenly energized, activated. I think the comet is going to activate them. What's happening right now is they're going to simply have this overwhelming belief in themselves and their mission, why they're here. And the demographics of the world, it's suddenly going to crystallize into this complete takeover, really. This ideological takeover of the planet. It is likely to occur, you know, it's occurring right now, actually. It's occurring right now. And Google has proclaimed they're going to now end human death. They're going to study human death, and they're going to come up with the answers. Really. That is funny. You know, this whole thing about search engine searching, you know, if you go to a garbage dump, what you're going to find is junk. You're going to find garbage there. And so, you know, garbage in, garbage out, as far as programming also. So, you search and search and search on the internet, but there's no content there. There's no real content at all. So this whole idea of this mighty search engine being so important, why? Why is it important? There's no information on the internet that I can find. I've never found any information, really, that's accurate, that's true, that's telling us that this is a death training program. Existence is a death-based training program. It's trying to teach us how to die. Where do you find that in the internet? Nowhere, except these videos. Nowhere. Nowhere, nowhere, nowhere. So we're trying to end human death. How about end all death? You know, who cares? You really want to live forever as a human surrounded by this dance of impermanence? Really? No. How about ending the dance of impermanence? How about ending the means of perception, which itself is impermanent, which is sensory perception? How do you do that? The only way to do that is the Holy Spirit. It's the only way. The Holy Spirit was specifically created by God to solve the continuity problem. Everything is driven by the continuity problem. Where do you get this information? Anywhere in the world, actually. So, it really doesn't matter what kind of search engine you have if you're just searching among junk, useless stuff. You're going to end up with useless stuff no matter what. So these times that we live in right now, this very day, it is, you might say it's the crossover day, it marks the beginning, I would say, of the new cycle. Maybe officially October 1st, you might say it will be. That this new cycle is no longer overlapping. We've kind of come out of the overlap phase. And I would say the changes are going to now be very rapid and very sweeping. The opposition to this new cycle has been crushed. We're going to get this, you know, new healthcare, affordable act, whatever, and this is an anathema to many people. The whole new cycle is an anathema to the ways of the old cycle, but both cycles are anathema to spirit, actually. And spirit doesn't like existence at all, but it's terrified of the continuity issue, terrified of feeling disoriented forever, feeling of disorientation. It sees this death training cycle as the lesser of two evils, and so it tries to embrace it, and tries to have a love affair with it. So spirit is carrying out this love affair with existence, but it really is very unfaithful. It hates existence. But it just says, wow, if I don't learn to love existence, I'm going to end up feeling eternally disoriented. So it's driven by fear. That the love that we have for existence is actually fear-based. This is something we need to understand. So it doesn't matter what cycle we have, it's still going to be fear-based. And people can talk about love all they want, but when you're trying to love existence, it is fear-based because you fear the alternative. You fear dropping perception, absolutely terrified of it. Believing it'll result in this eternal disorientation, which is, you know, so scary that we gladly get these bodies and have them die. We're glad to keep on this recycling, composting program we're on. It seems like way, way, way better. And if eternal disorientation was the case, it would be better. But it's not the case. It's not the case at all. Actually, we wouldn't suffer any disorientation whatsoever if we draw perception. But the ego has convinced us that we would. So we do need this intermediate step, the Holy Spirit showing us that no, we will not suffer any problem. But it is such a huge fear in our minds. Now, mind has been forced to put on this act of being the bad guy. But if we were just to allow ourselves to experience mind as it is, without trying to convince us that it's out to kill us, you know, then we would see the original risk. we can experience the incredible, inherent, pristine beauty of spirit of mind if we drop the demand to be prime creators, you see. But the new cycle is not dropping that demand. It's continuing on with trying to make exist, trying to keep this love affair with existence going, which is really a love affair with death. Let's put it in exactly the right terminology. It is a love affair with death. Okay. At least the process of trying to reach an ultimate death. All these little deaths are not ultimate deaths. None of this deaths that are happening will are ultimate death at all. They're like facsimiles, saying like, this is kind of what's going to happen with the ultimate death, but it's not quite it. You know, it's never quite it. So all the deaths that have ever happened have never been quite death. They've been saying, well, this is getting closer to what death really is. Well, how do you get close to nothing? How do you get closer to nothing? You cannot. So it's all been a waste of time. Nothing has ever really died. These little mini deaths are not really death at all. So nothing has died. Death has never happened. We're just defining all this stuff as, well, this is kind of like death. It's death-like. So all this death-like stuff has been happening. But there isn't any actual death at all. So this death-like training program that the mind has conjured up for us, we're addicted to it. I'll tell you what, this world is a zombie world. It's a world of zombies. We should name the planet Zombie. Because almost everyone on the planet are so blinded by the continuity fear. This fear of eternal disorientation of identity, not knowing who one is or how to function or anything. This extreme, eternal, endless disorientation. They're so utterly terrified of that they're completely blinded and driven to embrace the defense against this, the so-called alternative to this. And so they don't even question at all this embrace of death-like scenario. They just embrace it like zombies. See, zombies are just, you know, going after death, right? There's nothing going on. They're blinded inside their minds, and they're just acting like automatons, you know, searching to embrace death. That is literally the condition of almost everyone on this planet. Almost everyone on this planet are simply zombies. They're necrophiliacs, lovers of death, zombie necrophiliacs. And there's no reasoning with them. They're simply using, they're rationalizing their love of death by saying, oh yes, it's so wonderful. Dress it up, let's dress up these corpses and dance with these corpses. And that's what the world does. I've always found the world an extremely distasteful place. Horrible, horrible, horrible. The rituals, everything that people do, just action of zombies, and you can't get through to them. You say, what are you doing? You know, why are you embracing death? This is crazy. Don't you know that the continuity issue, the Holy Spirit has resolved it? And this is not our home. Don't you know all these things? And it makes no impression on them whatsoever. None. Nothing. They're like zombies. Zombies in pursuit of death, chasing their love of death. So a new cycle is just basically what it does is it works to make death more attractive again. You see, the old cycle of death was becoming very unattractive. We were getting tired of it, really. And the new cycle is dressing it back up again, saying, hey, let's dress it up again. Let's make it look real beautiful, very attractive. Let's accessorize it. And so spiritual truths have now just be turned into ways to dress up and accessorize our love of death. That's what's happened. I mentioned going into a New Age bookstore, how much it's changed over the last 33 years. It's just, you can't even recognize it. I mean, it's all about this faux spiritual accessorization of one's life. Everyone's saying, yeah, we're all into the new cycle. And look at all this cool spiritual accessories we can wear and do. And we're, you know, this is great. We love existence. We can be very spiritual beings. We can have it serve two masters. We can have it all. We can do it both. And we can love truth and also embrace death. And the real hardcore teachings that were built up before this overlay. Remember, the overlay of cycles, the stalemate, was the time of opportunity. There was a huge buildup of spiritual charisma and grace before this overlap happened, which is why teachers like Ramana Maharshi and Ananda Mahima and various other teachers, Punjaji, and there were other teachers, came before this overlap of cycles. They came before it to build up the momentum. And that's why the 60s was this incredible spiritual time where people were becoming aware of these great teachers, these great gurus that had been in the world, and were saying, this is what we need. This, and then the Course in Miracles came, and all that together enabled us to make this huge push during this last 33 years. Now, these gurus were not here during that time, but they had done their job. They had done their job and enabled us to skate past the obstacles somehow. And there were many obstacles, many, many obstacles. So that the new age will seem to be very glossy and very beautiful. That's what I experienced after the beach cleared away. There's all these young people on the beach, and they were absolutely frolicking about, and they looked so beautiful and so healthy and happy, and everything was sparkling. It was just sparkling, you know, just everything was glistening and sparkling, and people were just jubilant. But then later on that night, in a grocery store, I encountered this family with these young daughters. There's a mother with some young daughters, and these daughters were the most whorish females I've ever seen. It was incredible how they were dressed and acting in that grocery store. I was just like dumbfounded by it. And so suddenly it took a very sinister turn. The whole thing took a very sinister turn. I've never seen anyone like it before or since, as a matter of fact. The spirit of materialism was in them to an incredible extent. So I sort of was tipped off at that point and said, wow, what's going to happen is this new cycle is going to be super glossy and sparkly and seem to be, you know, the most wonderful thing, and the young people are going to drive it and seem so vibrant and healthy and beautiful. But it's going to take a very, very dark turn, materialism actually. And I've been working even more feverishly during this time to sidestep this whole situation, because it seems very attractive. Materialism can appear to be very attractive, just like the bloom of flowers. I just threw out some flowers here. They were all completely wrinkled, and the water was stinking, and they looked hideous. I just threw out them and threw out the water. At first, flowers seem very beautiful, but they turn into a rotting stench later. So this materialistic phase, we're going the new cycle, may appear to be, you know, wow. And interestingly enough, the gold iPhone 5 came out just a few days ago, right? Right at this time, the end of September. And they've sold, what, just incredible, record-breaking number of phones. Why? Simply because they basically made it colorful like flowers. You know, there's a few other little things, but people I've talked to say there's really no big difference. It's not significant at all, but you can get a gold one now. You can get a blue one, a red one, all these different colors. And so this new cycle is being kicked off by people saying, look how colorful, look how beautiful I am. It's being driven by the demographics, by design. And the old cycle will be made to appear very, very unattractive. Unattractive, even though there's tremendous wisdom, especially by people who've used this overlap, which is, I came into the world so I could benefit from this overlap time and make the most of it. Which I have done. But the old cycle is going to be like as passe as bell bottoms, you know, bell bottom pants. I mean, they have not come back really. I mean, you know, some style that just like is just nobody's going to say, oh, that is so out of style, so incredibly out of style. Are you kidding? You know, we're not going to ever go back to that. Forget it. So it'll seem that way, like you're just, the old cycle is so out of style. And again, the Pope is making it seem like the old Christianity is just so out of style, so out of touch. You know, just like, oh, how could you people be so ignorant and prejudiced and bigoted and so out of touch? I mean, wow, you need to get with it, you know. So it's making the old cycle look just incredibly stodgy and worse than stodgy, stupid and worse than stupid, you know, basically criminally stupid and out of sync. Criminally out of sync. And then you have, of course, today the announcement of the definitive climate study change. Now we have most of the scientists now have this big proclamation that yes, global warming is caused by humans. That is the cause, they're saying. Therefore, that gives this incredible push. That was another stalemate of, are humans really causing global climate change, or is it, you know, why are the other planets in the solar system heating up as well? You know, why are there massive changes on these other planets? There's no humans there. So that's been a big bone of contention. It seems as though that stalemate has been broken, and it's going to, those who oppose that this, you know, man-made climate change idea are going to be crushed. So you at the end of September, you have this incredible crushing of the stalemate. And you can probably think of all sorts of different things too, where not getting with the new paradigm is seen as criminally retarded, willful criminal retardation. And you have all the changes in the gun laws, like California is going to pass some sweeping gun laws, which is basically going to put, you know, gun stores out of business. And people who want to protect themselves, you know, their home and their loved ones, possessions, etc., from home invasions by criminals, they're seen as criminally insane, you know, at this point. They will be criminalized. I talk to gun owners, dialogue with them. I'm not a gun owner, but I talk with gun owners, and, you know, they're very sane people. And they say, well, you know what, we understand, you know, some of the restrictions make sense, et cetera, but in the bigger picture, what they're trying to do, we don't agree with it at all. Gun owners are actually very responsible people. It's the insane Manchurian candidate criminals that are the dangerous ones, you know, and that's what you need guns in to protect yourselves from that, actually. It's these, you know, deranged criminals that go into houses and go in and you know, if you don't have protection from them, you're too late. Calling the police is too late at that point. So you have this, I think the tide is turning in that direction by they're finding ways to basically say you can't make any repairs on guns, you can't add any parts, you can't change parts, no repairs, etc., no lead ammunition, no this, all this stuff. It is crushing. That'll be crushed too. So this new cycle is absolutely crushing at this point, and the stalemate's been broken. There's a certain point in time, like you have a log jam, where suddenly the log jam is broken. Now, all of this is going to happen very fast. They repaved our roads recently, and first they put down the rock undercoating with rock and some tar, and they let that sit for a while. And we thought, oh, well, this is going to take quite some time. Then one morning, they showed up with a slurry machine, and in a half an hour, the road was finished. By that afternoon, it had dried and hardened, and you could drive on. It was done just like that. So putting on the final coat can take place with incredible rapidity. I would say by this Christmas, it's going to be done. It's going to be done. That's how fast it is going to take place. So the logjam, the stalemate, has been broken. And I anticipated this. I knew it was coming. No question. You know, those who kept preaching that no, we can win this. The old cycle, people of the old cycle, the voices of it saying, we can stop this. We can stop this. You know, I always knew, no, you're not going to be able to stop it. And it's stupid to use your time in that way. You should be using your time to tune in to the Holy Spirit, to the Christ child within, to the truth within, and to recognize what the remedy is, to how do we overcome our fear of letting go of perception. Okay, first we see the perfect no, which is for a no to be a no, it has to be saying no to something. So it's saying no to all this impermanence, that the impermanence saying yes, impermanence is saying yes, we can die. The perfect no says no, we can't. But it's saying no to the yes, we can. So the yes, we can is still there. So you're still perceiving, but you now know within you there's a knowing, a no, we can't. There's this perfect no. I'm aware that all this death-like activity will never result in death. You might call existence just this massive amount of death-like activity, but it never leads to death. It doesn't lead anywhere. It's just a senseless wandering about. Just senseless wandering about. Never leads to death. So those who were standing up for the old regime, I knew that they would be crushed. The stalemate would end. They would lose. Which is, and I tried to tell them. I tried to warn everybody that this is what's going to happen. And so you better be prepared for that. A lot of people say, no, we're going to stand up and fight for the old regime. I said, you know, you're going to be crushed. You're going to be crushed. And you'd better have another option available if you don't really want to suffer this crushing. But so I've been speaking out on this continuously because plus the people of the new regime, I've been speaking out about telling, hey, you're not going to like it. You're going to have buyer's remorse. So you have buyer's remorse, the new regime. The old regime is going to be in despair because they're going to lose. And I said, you better have this this other option of salvation by the grace of the Holy Spirit. You better get familiar with it. You better be familiar with this or by the time of when the stalemate is broken, or else you're going to be in big, big, big trouble. And I believe this October 1st date is significant. So somehow it's known in advance that there's going to be this cosmic trigger where the old regime is going to realize that they lost. And there's a fear that there's going to be civil unrest, actually, starting at that point, probably, going forward. And so there's been massive preparations to suppress any civil disobedience, civil disorder. It's not going to be like the 60s, where there was so much tolerance for civil dissent, protest, anti-war protests. It's not going to be like that at all. It's going to be brutally suppressed. Anything happened, brutally suppressed. And all the executive orders are in place. The definition of the people from the old regime was supported. They're literally defined as enemy combatants now, as terrorists, actually. According to the Homeland Security and the manuals, etc., they're now defined as terrorists. So, you know, the whole situation is not going to be like the days of the anti-war protests, free speech movement, all that stuff. No way, no how. And you've had all these various false flag situations that have scared the people and thinking, oh my gosh, we need to make, you know, we must listen to authority, we must allow authority to crack down on these people, etc. Crack down. They can say, well, they're mentally unstable, and defined as those who don't support the new cycle will be defined as mentally unstable. And then they'll say we have to take their guns away, and we have to, you know, on and on and on and on and on. And everybody knows it's coming. So it's here. And you better have that third option in place, which I've been preaching, which frees us all, helps us sidestep the entire scenario. And of course, a lot of people don't have that in place. And it's Or they might just lapse into, you know, just sort of this apathy and despair and start ghost dancing, as it were. That's possible too. The mood of defiance, it seems to be lessening more and more and more as people just kind of think, wow, you know, I don't know what's going on. I just feel this kind of apathy creeps in, depression creeps in, anxiety creeps in. They stop being able to sleep. I haven't been able to sleep, having trouble sleeping, because I knew this something significant's happening, and now I know it's the end of the stalemate. It's over, and that means it's the grace period is over, and so what's going to happen? The Holy Spirit will act for sure. It will act the way it always acts, through grace and the offering of options. So we needed this overlap period to come to an end finally, so we could decide where we're going to go. What are we going to do now? Because the options are now clear. It's either the new cycle or death. You know, basically, you're going to be conglomerated into the new World Order Corporation, which is the new cycle, and you're going to continue on as a zombie for sure. Or you can take refuge in what the Holy Spirit has planned. So the stress and the weariness of this last month, actually, it's just been incredible. I mean, I feel hardly able to function or move at all. Just very tired and wiped out from the battle, as it were, to inform people correctly. And of course, there's sympathy with the old cycle. There's sympathy, because I've certainly been part of that. And, you know, you don't like to see anyone get crushed. And so, even though I know the old cycle was very much mistaken too, still there's a lot there, you know, there's a lot there. And so it is very disheartening to witness its demise, for sure. And knowing that the new cycle is nothing but here comes trouble, you know, here comes trouble. Knowing that and the trouble people are going to go through, that's also very disheartening. So it's a very disheartening time to also know that the cycle of grace is over. So this stalemate time is over, and not many have made the grade, really. Not really, and you have to wait, maybe you have to wait to another overlap cycle. You know, it's very possible that the next overlap will maybe be the next time of greatest opportunity, and have to prepare for that, which is in the future, and do a better job of that. So having gone through this overlap time, I have experience now, and those who have gone through this will have experience. They say, well, how can we do a better job next time? Help more of us make the grade next time. And I think what happens, I think, is that spiritual teachers, once you accept the Holy Spirit's perfect no, which is the perfect stalemate's all of time and space, you become a bona fide spiritual teacher, a spiritual master, as it were. And what you do then is you go to different planets throughout the cosmos right before there's a stalemate period coming, overlapping of cycles, because cycles are continuously going on throughout all of existence. And you show up there, and you give people reason to hope, so that then they can benefit when the overlap of cycles stalemate period occurs, they can make the grade. So I believe that's how it works. So for sure, somewhere in the cosmos, there are probably many, 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 many places in the cosmos right now where it's this time of just before an overlap occurs, just before this overlap stalemate time occurs, which then, if you want to help out, you can take a birth there as a spiritual teacher, And people will be amazed, you know, by you and just think like, wow, what is this? What is this? What's going on? This is a great grace of God's coming here. And then when the overlap stalemate time takes place, they will be able to say, no, wait a minute. Neither of these cycles is right. And the light starts to go on. Okay. So that seems to be quite the opportunity. The opportunity. But as far as this planet or the people involved in this, you know, it's going to take them a while. Once they get into fourth dimension, they get buyer's remorse. Eventually, buyer's remorse comes. And then eventually a cycle will overlap their cycle, and then they can, you know, get perspective on it and say, hey, wait a minute, I don't want to go into a new cycle. The old one was bad, but I don't want a new one. I'm tired of all this. And then they can make the grade at that time. So I believe that's what's going to happen. That's why yesterday I quit. I didn't play the 18th hole. I went to the driving range, and I ironed out my shots. So I was completely satisfied. I said, wow, it is possible to hit it just dead straight, just perfect. And it was easy for me. So in other words, it's time to retreat, get aligned perfectly with truth, and know, oh yes, this definitely this is doable. We can help out. We can come into a place before the overlap period occurs, the stalemate period occurs. Help build up the yes, the no, no, we can't, to the yes, we can. Okay, no, we can't learn how to die. We can't. No matter how much we follow this death-like scenario, we will never die. Build that realization up, like this deathless feeling. The great guru is bringing this deathless feeling, this feeling of eternal life, and people resonate with that. And then when the overlap occurs, they can say, you know what? Neither cycle seems right. I want eternal life. And that gives them the opportunity to make an all-out push. So I've lived it. I've experienced it. So I know it's possible. So again, we are now in this, you know, incredible time where people will either go into the new cycle, form some sort of desultory resistance to it that is just going to get crushed, or accept the Holy Spirit's offer of sanctuary, retreat, sanctuary, a place of rest, a place of getting, you know, perfect alignment without the pressures, and getting ready to be of service in some place in space and time, if called to be, if called to that. And we're at that time right now. So I expect a lot of stuff to start happening right now. A lot of stuff. And it will. It most certainly will. So that's why I've been pushing, saying, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Your time is limited. Once this stalemate is broken, that's it. And it's been broken. It's been broken. The ice has been breaking. Finally, the ice shelf has now broken with this Iran-U.S. thawing, as it were. You can feel that the geopolitical stalemates are starting to break. As the younger demographic is supporting the new world order and the new cycle, they're in full support of it, and they believe they're going to be gods and goddesses on this incredible planet, and they're going to turn it into a paradise and all this kind of stuff. And so they've finally gained the upper hand enough to break the stalemate. And so they're celebrating. I mean, the celebration is just going to sweep the world, actually, to tell you the truth. And if you oppose it, you're just going to seem to be nothing. You know, you're criminally insane or retarded, actually. Really. That whole rationale has been put in place that you are, you know, endangering the new cycle. It's criminal. It's all here now. It's all here. It's all here, and the ball is going to be rolling now very, 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 very fast. But also the Holy Spirit's going to get his ball rolling very, very, very fast. for me, I just need to just keep breathing, basically. Because as far as doing anything, I don't feel like I can do anything. Like, I feel like heavy as lead. Because it's over as far as, you know, what do you do as far as trying to warn people? Well, you know, that's over. The stalemate is over. That time of grace is over. So it now is simply, we'll see what the next phase is. We'll see what the next phase is, how that plays out. But it's difficult to align with any sort of action at this point, which is why I'm feeling so tired. When you know what you want to do, then you get the energy, you align your energy, and its energy starts to, you know, flow, and you feel confident, etc. But if you don't know what to do, you're very ambivalent, then you feel just this terrible, terrible nervous strain, you know, just like, wow, horrible. So it should be a memorable time right now, for sure. And as always, we will see how it goes. Just keep breathing. Just wherever you are, just keep breathing. And if you feel leaden, if you feel, you know, just like you just can't marshal your life force, you can't marshal yourself at all, don't worry about that. Just keep breathing and say, okay, this is going to pass. This will pass, and something will come into focus. Will really come into focus now. Just get through this time, and don't demand so much of yourself. I took it easy on myself, actually. I had to. So I just can't get myself to do anything really at this point, except to make this taping, which I'm able to do that. But as far as action in the world, I try to take action. My body feels like it's made of spaghetti. I cannot get myself to do anything, hardly. Eat, sleep, and tape. But other than that, not really. Because the landscape is now, it's changed. It's really changed. Fortunately, the dust, I was at the dump today, and someone was just pouring all this dirt out on the ground, and I said, oh my gosh. Then they took a blower, a gas blower, and started blowing the truck bed out, and just huge billows of dust were going out. But the wind was very strong, and it was carrying it right away from me. I didn't get touched by the dust at all. This is just an incredible amount of dust. And the one doing the blowing was blowing right back in his face. He was just getting like hammered by all this dust, and I didn't get touched by it. It's a very good sign. So the dust up, which the mop-up operation, which could come or might not come, is for to the old regime. It depends on how much the old regime resists. It may just crumble. But if it resists, there's most certainly going to be mop-up measures taken, for sure. And those who really act out will be re-educated, to say the least. I'm gonna sidestep all of that. It's not necessary to go through that. I understand what's taking place. Did my utmost to help, to warn people. Say, look, don't count on victory. The old regime, don't count on victory. You can't count on it. You're outnumbered. The whole thing, the whole blueprint is going against you entirely. And you better be prepared, spiritually prepared. So I start out the video saying, look, you need to get into some spiritual teaching. So whatever you can find that is this higher teaching, really this higher teaching, you better find it and start getting familiar with it. You don't have to embrace it, just get familiar with it. That is the key component, just get familiar with it. So you can listen to it and say, oh yeah, I understand what's going on. And then at some point you might be able to see the bigger picture. Okay, just like today, the whole bigger picture just clicked into place. The stalemate's over, the overlapping of cycles, the 33-year cycle of overlap. It's interesting that Jesus', you know, death and crucifixion basically ended after 33 years. Okay, it's very symbolic. The overlap, apparently the overlap between cycles is a 33-year cycle. So what Jesus was showing us was that you can use these 33 years to sidestep, to transcend, and to accept the intermediate step, the resolution of the continuity issue that prepares you for eternal life. You can prepare for eternal life if you use these 33 years in the right way. So it's extremely significant that Jesus returned with the Course in Miracles right before this 33-year cycle took place, and enabled us then to have this when it started. So I was already into it just before this 33-cycle stalemate happened, and then I was able to use this to plow through the times and stay afloat and not get tricked into a new cycle, and not get pulled into trying to prop up the old cycle. Both things tried to grab me. The old cycle tried to get me to prop it up, most definitely, and the new cycle tried to get me to provide the soundtrack to attract people into the new cycle. Both cycles were trying to use me. And I said, you know, neither one, I said, no, no. And gradually I've been able to, you know, say no to both of the cycles. But for a while, it was horrible. As both cycles were battling each other, they came to me and saying, can you please help us? We're desperate, and we know you have capabilities to help. Can you help us? Just do your part, whatever it is. And so I didn't want to say no to this. I didn't want to say no to that. So I tried to please both of them. And then that just eventually was like tearing me apart. Horrible. So eventually I've gotten to the point saying no to both of them. But that's the ultimate, is if you can say no to both of the overlapping cycles, then you've made it. You've used your time wisely. That's why night before last, the Christ child showed up in my dreams and said, he said you brush your teeth, you know, really, really well. You know, great job. You really know how to do it. Cleaning bowl open both upper and lower. See the teeth, upper set, lower set. One cycle, another cycle, you know, coming together. And brushing means you clean both the upper and the lower, because he was watching me and I was cleaning both the upper and the lower. And he said, yeah, I really like what you've done. You've done it just right. So that's the cleansing from both cycles. You see, you remove yourself from both upper and lower sets of teeth, from both cycles. And the bite is when the cycles come together. The bite is that 33-year period where you feel really this pressure, this tremendous pressure from both cycles, the old and the new. And if you follow the grace of the Holy Spirit, you're able then to eventually get a perspective on the whole thing. And you say, not neither. Neither, don't need it. I just need the perfect no, the perfect stalemate. Perfect stalemate, now just abide in that. So it appears there's lots of indications that I may have made the grade. We'll see. I'm not counting my chickens before they hatch. But certainly it seems to be, you know, dawning and going that direction. So, you know, we'll see. I'm not going to make any proclamations or anything like that at this point, that's for sure. But I certainly hope that it is. And keep aligning with that. So hopefully in hearing all this, you're having these aha moments like, wow, I see something coming into focus that I didn't see before. And you say, yeah, now I see what's going on. Very interesting. At least it gives you this dawning, like there is a big picture and it is possible to see it. It is possible to get free of it. It is possible to set yourself up in the right direction. All right. So stay tuned. We'll see what happens next. That's it. Very good.